Movie dialogue that I remember, the first 15 minutes of Superbad, it's definitely got some interesting quotable lines in there.
Last of the Mohicans, right? When they're in the waterfall, I will find you. I was like, yo, that's so romantic.
I guess my favorite line of dialogue that I could think of is probably in Casablanca. You know, they said the water would be good. He said, but there is no water. It's just a great way to say, I don't want to talk about that.
I was obsessed with Moulin Rouge as a child. I don't know why. Maybe that. Maybe I shouldn't have even been watching it so young. But I didn't understand the full situation. But I knew that I was obsessed with that damn movie.
I believe you were expecting me.
Yes. Pee-wee Herman's Big Adventure. I watched it every single day after school. And I used to have these pink Converse that I would wear. And I would try to do the tequila dance every day.
Ed Zwick's Glory. I had the battle scene. I knew all the blocking. I would attach this like number two pencil to this rifle I had for it to be like the bayonet that they had. They would attach the bayonets to their rifles. That movie was just, it just speaks to me every time.
What film from childhood do I still have on VHS? Probably Return of the Living Dead 3.
I remember I had Anastasia. And then also I used to be obsessed with Barney. So I had like every Barney tape out there. That was my shit. But also, my grandfather loved Laurel and Hardy. When I was younger, he had switched over to DVDs, and he gave me all the Laurel and Hardy tapes, which I still have for some reason. I obviously can't watch them, but I still have them.
You're so good at fighting. You fought to make the movie, to make it the way you wanted to make it, so why didn't you fight for me?
An actor or actress I always admired as a child. One of them, I remember watching What's Love Got to Do with It with my grandmother. Angela Bassett is like everything, still is everything. She's stunning. She's just like talented, gorgeous. Just, I love her.
I mean, Alfre Woodard is one of the greats. She has this ability to be so intense, to be strong, militant Black woman, but she also can make you laugh. Not everybody can do that, can do both.
Is that what that mean, baby?
Si, querida mamacita.
Don't call me mama, Blair Underwood.
All right.
I admire her as an actress so much. De Niro, you know, obviously, who doesn't, right? I love De Niro. Robin Williams, those are some, just to name a few.
You just need a reason to be needed. Because if I don't need you, then what the hell am I doing with you, Marie? You want control, because you can't imagine the reason I'm with you is because I love you.
Well, I think it kind of already has become a classic. Moving forward, but Moonlight, I think, is very much a classic and should be regarded as such. That would be one that I think is going to be a cinema staple.
40-year-old version. It's just remarkable.
Get on, better write me some poverty porn.
So there's some movies that you don't want to touch. I would like to be in Life. You know, the movie Life, what Martin and Eddie did. I mean, that was Oscar-worthy performances to me personally. They were incredible in that movie. And maybe I would like to attempt, but see, I'd be intimidated because I know they did it already and it's untouchable. But I would love to try to insert myself into tracking a character from that time to from the age they start to where they finish.
A project I would love to participate in 2021. I don't know, I mean, hopefully Sam will write me some more movies. You know, hopefully he'll be open to writing me something else. Who knows what his brain will come up with. Maybe it will be a psychological horror this time. We don't know. So I'm gonna keep bothering him until he writes me something.
I saw Pieces of a Woman. There's a sequence in there that's, I can't get it out of my head. So that's up there. Anything Christopher Nolan does, he did something that came out this year. I put that up there. Biased to say, but I think this film that is Malcolm and Marie, I mean, I really do feel that way about this. This is something special. Thinking about where I was even in my 20s, in my teenage years, to see two African Americans in black and white film this way, I don't think I've ever seen it. To see it being presented this way, I think I would say Malcolm and Marie.
Well, you know that I made a mistake, so why turn it into something more?
Because it's about how you see this relationship. Look at me. I'm the last person standing.